Welcome in our Learning for Knowledge YouTube channel. Today we are starting another series of lectures related with the water systems. In these videos, we will explain the cooling water systems and then cooling towers and different aspects of cooling water related systems which are used in the industry. First of all, in this video, we will describe three major types of cooling systems known as open, closed, once through cooling systems. So let's move towards video. Systems. What is the role of cooling water system in the industry or in the power plant? Basically, cooling water system widely used to remove heat generated in a industrial process in a different variety of ways. Like in power plants, it is used to cool the steam and other industrial processes. Like in the production of chemicals, it is used to cool the system and different processes. So what is going to be happen in these cooling systems? Basically, they transfer the heat. Cooling water takes the heat from heat exchangers or other heat transfer equipments and then reject this heat into the environment. This is the basic main role of cooling water systems. There are mainly three types of cooling water systems. One, once through cooling system. Second, open recirculating system. Closed recirculating system. You know, once through cooling system and closed recirculating system, both are these known as non-evaporative. While open recirculating system is known as evaporative system. We will describe one by one these three systems. Now, the cooling water system operates on evaporative and non-evaporative principle. So what are these? In non-evaporative systems like once through and closed cooling water system, heat rejection basically took place by a property of water which is known as specific heat capacity of water. That is the amount of energy 1 BTU required to transfer the heat of 1 pound of water and change of per degree Fahrenheit temperature. Or in other units, it is 4.19 kilojoules per kg per degree Celsius or centigrade amount of energy. This is the amount of energy transferred or required or dissipate, whatever you want to define with respect to any of your system. That is 4.19 kilojoule of amount of energy is dissipated or rejected per kg of water per degree centigrade change in temperature. This is known as non-evaporative basically principle. While in the other, which is open recirculating water system, like a cooling tower system, where water is evaporated. Now, in this evaporation, phase changes took place, that is from liquid to gas, and then dissipates. This phase change dissipates about 1000 BTU per pound or 2300 kilojoule per kg of water converted to vapor. So this much amount is dissipated when water is converted into vapor. So more energy is dissipated in the environment. So more energy is rejected or transferred in the atmosphere. So more cooling effect took place in this open recirculating system, which is based on evaporation. Now, evaporative systems can dissipate 50 to 100 times, depending upon the design of the system, more heat to the environment per unit of the water as compared to non-evaporative system like closed cooling water system or once through system. So this is basically main difference that in these three types, two are based on non-evaporative, that is no evaporation of water took place, while in one type of system, which is open recirculating, the evaporation took place and it is more efficient as compared to other two types. Now, we will describe here once through cooling tower system. Once through cooling tower system, as it is obvious from its name, that this takes the water from the source, which is a cold water or cool water, and then it send in this water, we send this water into the system, and when it take the heat from the system, then we will send back this system to the our source water, and no recirculation took place. The point where we will suck or take the water, we will not reject at the same point after the heat dissipation. So, but overall, overall the body of the source of water is same, but the point of suction and discharge are not same. So in once through the entire system, in the once through system, the water is returned to the receiving body of water. This type of system requires abundant water supply and is commonly found along rivers or seashores, because when we discharge or discard the water, we need fresh water, which must be at low temperature as compared to dissipated temperature, and the stream of that source took that rejected heat, which is come from hot water, away from the cold point, and we can use plenty of water in these type of system. Big power utility normally use these type of system, which is once through cooling water. This is a schematic or generalized, you can say, diagram. Like, this is a source of cool water. We take intake from this with the help of some pump and send it to this heat exchanger or heat transfer surfaces, and then after taking the heat from this, in this process, this water which we took from this source now discharge on the other side, and it will not recycled. Or, and in another form, we take this water, supply of water, and we divide this water for cooling purposes of different parts like heat exchanger, pump seal, compressor jacket, bearings, and then after cooling these parts, the water will be discharged and not recycled. This is once through system. Very simple. Now we come towards closed recirculating system. A closed recirculating system, as it is obvious from its name, is that the water present in this system is reused, recycled. So a closed recirculating system is one in which the water is circulated in a closed loop, and the system is sealed, no leakage took place, no replacement of water took place. Sometimes this system is under pressure and is not open to the atmosphere. No evaporation takes place, and water is used to provide heating, cooling, or both for industrial processes. This is called closed recirculating system. Now the heat which is taken by this closed recirculating system is now usually dissipated by an open recirculating cooling system or by an air cooling in a fin fan cooler. This is another example. In general, water treatment for closed system is much easier than for open systems. This is the advantage. So this is the schematic. Here we have a closed loop. This is the heat, this is the pump where we will send the water, and this is the main process in which this closed loop water take the heat from the system and then come and then again reject its heat to this open loop system. So basically this is two loops involved in this, because after this because the temperature increases, and if we will not cool this water, then it will not be further able to cool this main process. So this is also used in some of the industrial processes, and it has some advantages and some drawbacks. Maybe we will discuss this in the coming videos later on. And third one is open recirculating system. Very important. The system is open to the atmosphere, and continuously recycle and reuse the cooling water. Now, because this is open to atmosphere, that's why, although it is recirculating, it is in somehow it is closed, but one end of this is open and it is open to atmosphere, and at that point it rejects its heat. This type of system is comprised of an evaporator unit, a cooling tower, or an evaporative condenser. These units mix air and water and allow some of the water to evaporate and cooling the balance of the water volume, because due to evaporation the remaining water will become cold, because due to evaporation some temperature drops, dropping of the temperature occurs. This is the evaporation phenomena. Now the cooled water is taken from the basin or pond and circulated to heat exchanger or chiller, whatever our process. Heat from these equipment is taken by the cooling water, thereby removing the heat. The warmed water is then circulated to the cooling tower and cycle is repeated. Then after water is cooled from in this cooling tower, it will send back again to our system. The open recirculating system repeats this process of reuse, and water is lost from the system primarily through evaporation. So some water lost in the process of evaporation. However, a portion of the cooling water must be discharged as waste. That is, other than evaporation losses, we have to discard or discharge some water that is known as blowdown from the system. Why? Because it is important to control the quality of water within the system. Because when water evaporates, it will not take any of the solid impurities with it. So the solid impurities are now concentrating in the remaining water, and we have to convert, or we have to, you can say, discard some amount of the water, and we will add some fresh water to balance the quality of the water. Otherwise the water will become more and more corrosive or scaling. That is, the impurities increases and it will lead to the scale formation or corrosion in the system. That's why we have to discard or blow down, better term is blow down, some of portion of the water. So all water lost from the system is replaced. The water lost due to evaporation or due to blow down, we will replace with the fresh makeup water. And reuse of water, the remaining water is reused, and that's why the reuse of water greatly reduce water demand and discharge or blow down. So this is the schematic of open recirculating system. Here you can say this is the basin from where cold water is taken and sent to this heat exchanger. Now it take the heat from this process, and again some of the blow down, some water need to be discarded or blow down, and then remaining will be sent it to cooling tower. Now the water is spread or sent to this cooling tower depending upon the design of cooling tower, and then it mix with the air, cooled air, and then the air take the heat from this water and also some of the water particles, and then evaporate from this fan, and remaining water is now cold and now come into this basin and then again reused or recycled from this process. So this is the general schematic process of the open recirculating system. So these are basically three main types of the cooling water system and used as per the requirement of the industry. But this open recirculating system is much more famous and more efficient as compared to closed cooling water system and once through system, because in other than efficiency, in once through system more water is required. That's why in this areas where the water is not available and plenty of quantity of water is available, that is not preferred. And in closed system we have to couple it with another open recirculated for the ultimate rejection of the heat. That is, the closed system sometimes requires, due to some special reason or special requirement, of the system, or for basically small units, small system of HVAC like air conditioning system, which are smaller, and then a closed system is used, air used to control or take the heat from the system. And in the coming slide we will discuss further on this cooling tower and other aspects of cooling water systems. So thank you very much, and see you in the next videos.